It's Friday, February 18th. Welcome to this week's show.
Today we have
interview with Mr. Ricklick about President's Day,
a cupfang challenge,
and much more on this week's
Roadrunner Report.
Hey Maz, did you know President's Day is celebrated every third Monday of February?
I heard Jacoby had a talk with Mr. Ricklick about President today.
Oh, that's interesting. Let's
cut to the clip.
Hi, I'm Jacoby, and I'm here with Mr. Ricklick, and our discussion today is how did President's Day start? What's its origin?
Well, President's Day is a federal holiday, which means, you know, banks are closed and we're out of school. It's celebrated on the third Monday of every February, which is like in 2 weeks. So in 2 weeks, you're off for President's Day. But what day? President's Day. Whose birthday? Not George Washington's. That's not his birthday. His birthday is actually on February 22nd, but it never falls on his birthday. Anyway, we'll get to that in a second. What other question do you have?
What was its origin and how did it start?
Well, you know, our beloved first president was like a national hero. I mean, we've got the Washington Monument in D.C. We've got the Purple Heart, which is awarded to all of those who fight in battle and are injured, and it's got an image of him on there. So he is renowned in our country as a pillar of our history. So we need to celebrate his birthday.
Mm.
But it was on February 22nd, and so what we have to do is, let me get to it. So it was unofficial, actually. For almost 100 years, we celebrated his birthday unofficially. Well, they needed to make it official. At the time, his birthday joined four other recognized federally banked holidays. Did you know the first four federal holidays? Can't look at my notes.
New Year's Day.
Good.
July 14th, or no, 4th of July, sorry.
There's two.
Abraham Lincoln's birthday? No, President says one of them.
Uh-uh.
Oh, really?
Not yet. No, it came, but what was the first four? You got two of them.
Is Christmas one of them?
Christmas.
Okay. St. Patrick's Day. No?
We eat a lot of food with family.
Oh, Thanksgiving.
Okay. There's our four. And then number five was the first time we actually nationally recognized a person. All those are events, right? Historical events. So the fifth one was George Washington's. By the way, the next holiday that was recognized by an individual, Martin Luther King. Mm. That's another story. But we have national days for like everything. Do you know what the national day is today?
No, what is
it? It's the National Boy Scouts Day. It's the National Fly a Kite Day. Just look it up, Google it. So Washington's birthday was the first to celebrate the life of an individual, like I said. It was moved though, in 1971, one of the congressmen said, it's always on the 22nd and we need to move it to a Monday. And we're gonna move four other holidays to a Monday. And they did, they passed in 1971, so we have four holidays like President's Day, Columbus Day, Memorial Day, and they did have Veterans Day as a holiday. Now why on Mondays? Why would you want to have a holiday on a Monday? Yeah. You like holidays on Monday, don't you?
Yeah.
Who wants a 3-day weekend? I do. And so does a lot of other people. So it was good for business. Actually, it generated the economy to move these holidays to a Monday.
Mm.
Did you know that President's Day never falls on his actual birthday? In fact, we have George Washington, William Henry Harrison, all presidents, Abraham Lincoln, and Ronald Reagan. They do not fall on President's Day. It just doesn't work in the calendar. However, my birthday falls on the President's Day once every 7 years.
Hmm.
When's my birthday? None of your business! That's right. It is none of your business when my birthday is. And I shall never tell the truth.
All right, I think that's what we got all for today.
Is it? Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Do you have any questions?
Mm-hmm. No, I don't
either. Let's do it.
Hey, Hey, Maz, what's your favorite type of candy?
My favorite type of candy is Reese's. What's your favorite type of flower, Val?
My favorite type of flowers are roses.
We interviewed a few roadrunners for their opinion.
Let's rise to the clip.
Hi, I'm Brianna. I'm here with
Aaliyah,
Anna,
Belle.
And today's question is, what's your favorite type of flower?
Sunflowers.
Roses.
Tulips.
Okay, thank you. Hi, I'm Brianna. I'm here with
Giancarlo.
Alexis.
Martin.
And today's question is, what's your favorite candy?
Push Pops.
Sour Patch Kids.
Snickers.
Okay, thank you. Hi, I'm Brianna. I'm here with
Frankie.
And today's question is, what's your favorite candy?
Reese's.
Okay, thank you.
Hey, are you good at basketball?
Yeah, I'm pretty decent.
If you're good at basketball, then you should play Cup Pong. We challenged some roadrunners during fifth period lunch.
Let's shoot to the clip.
My name is Mazin, and I'm here with
Tyler.
Marcus Rodino.
And do you guys want to participate in a throw a ball in the cup challenge?
Oh, yeah, sure.
I'm down.
Okay, winner gets 10 Prescott prides. Let's see who wins. Marcus is the winner.
Let's go, baby.
But thank you for participating, Tyler.
Thanks.
Okay, have a good rest of your
Skibo
day.
Skibo bop.
4 7th grade students performed National History Day in the library last week.
I saw them presented their project in the library.
It turned out really good.
Let's go to the library.
I'm Kaylee Butler.
I'm a Burkett.
Arabella Port.
Sophie Rhodes Cranford.
And this is
Arise in Feminism.
Seneca Falls, 1848.
We hope you enjoy.
Existing without the consent of the governed, declare our right to be free as man is free, to be represented in the government which we are taxed to support, to have such disgraceful laws as give man the power to chastise and imprison his wife, to take the wages which she earns, the property which she inherits, and in case of separation, the children of her love.
Change must expect opposition, because it shakes the very foundation of privilege.
We hold these truths to be self-evident, that all men are created equal.
300
women
and men,
only about 100
signed the Declaration of Sentiments and Resolutions.
But not every woman agreed with equal rights. They were scared of the repercussions.
Day 2.
The holding of what is technically styled as a women's rights convention. The speaking, addresses, and resolutions of this extraordinary meeting were almost wholly conducted by women. The North Star editorial, The Rights of Women.
Good afternoon, Jane. I'm so glad you were able to help out with the convention, and I believe it was mostly a success. Look here, we're in the Daily News.
I am very aware, however, I don't believe the publicity they're giving us in the news is what we want to hear.
Thank you.
Bro, what the heck? Why'd you trip me, man?
Because it's funny.
Isn't that funny, man?
Oh, they're arguing. They're fighting.
Dude, you okay?
Yeah. Thanks, man.
Welcome.
Here. Thanks, man. Alright. I'll see you later, man.
See you later.
Bye.
Bye. Thank you.
Well, that's the end of our show for this week.
Thanks for watching, and we'll see you next Friday.
Have a great three-day weekend. Bye.
Our discussion today is, how did President's Day start, and what's its origin?
I don't know. I thought you knew. What, that didn't work? Excuse me.
This is how this goes, you know. This is normal.
Raid the gritty. I mean, Brian,
Wow, how distinguished. You're gonna, are you rolling?
It's rolling.
Father, I cannot tell a lie. For it was I that chopped down the cherry tree. I am so sorry. So sorry. So sorry.